they have come from 400 kilometers one way. 800 kilometers one way, I'm sorry. One way 800 kilometers from Yangon. It's like an iron butt, like 1600 kilometers, just to meet us. Is that right? Just to meet us?
Yeah, exactly.
As XBHP, we had already done over 50 countries on some of the world's best superbikes and sometimes supercars too. Before the start of this odyssey from India all the way to Singapore and beyond to Sri Lanka via Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, Thailand, Laos, Vietnam, Cambodia and Malaysia. And this would be a total of 15,000 kilometers in 90 days for a total of 11 countries. And we would be doing this on a homegrown Bajaj Dominar 400. Not only that, there will be 11 riders who will be joining us in different legs of this odyssey. But you have to see all the vlogs one by one to find out who they were. So guys, here I am standing in the ancient city of Bagan, where there are still 4,000 pagodas, temples, stupas, and it was told that once upon a time there were around 10,000 of these structures, even more beautiful than this. This is actually made of brick, but a lot of such pagodas, they have golden spires, and those that gold does not get dull. I mean, it's not a paint, I don't know what it is, but you know, have a there's a bike, the Dominar is running absolutely beautiful, and have a look at this, come from this angle. This window shows you Gautam Buddha inside, and it's such a beautiful, serene feeling to see him over there. And I mean, you know, it's so quiet, and this whole place is like, you know, it's not swamped with tourists, and it's the way we don't see too many of these temples in India. I mean, like in India, there are always mostly a lot of people, you know, and in numbers, like in buses, and you know, crowding all over. But I tell you, this is the place where we have been standing, doing our photography, and just, you know, soaking in for the last couple of hours, and that says something. So if you take an aerial view, you will see hundreds of such structures, and most of them have Buddhas also outside, not only inside, and that's a stupendous sight. So I'm thankful that, you know, I visited Myanmar. It's been long due on my list, and it started raining. Perhaps even the gods, they want to thank, you know, say like welcome to Myanmar or something. This whole Southeast Asian belt, we will not get cold. It will be only humid, and it will be less rain. If we had come around 3 months ago, it would have been impossible for us to even ride. There would have been so much rain all over this belt. But I guess that is what the balance is. It's cooled down a little bit right now. It's so humid, unbelievable. But we're having a nice time. It kept raining in Bagan the day we were there, and it was getting very slippery. But that did not stop us from exploring it the way we wanted to. Wow, this is amazing. Look at all this. And again, wherever you see a lot of pagodas, is like riding in Amazon. Oh my god, this part is slippery. Okay. Wow. The tires are doing an amazing job. Oh. Moss is not good.
The Bajaj Dominar 400 is an amazing motorcycle to tackle all kind of terrains, as we found out. It is a very proud feeling to ride an Indian-made motorcycle all the way from India to Singapore and beyond. But there are a lot of you who are just starting out the life on two wheels. And for that, Bajaj has launched the perfect weapon, the Dominar 250. The Dominar 250 looks promising and you can test ride it at your nearest Bajaj dealership. But for now, let's get back to the Odyssey.
So this seems to be the traditional art here in Myanmar. It's beautiful the way they are hanging in the air. And so these are apparently umbrellas. And I don't know, this guy is very happy. Seems like a farmer to me. But a lot of resemblance to how we do things in India. On my left, on my right. Oh my god. I think there must be more pagodas and temples here than houses.
म्यांमार में आए और वहाँ की जो ट्रेडिशनल थाली है वो नहीं खाई तो क्या खाया? तो ये रही, वैसे ये वाली ज़्यादा सही लग रही है. सुनील जी, आपको मालूम है कि क्या क्या इसके अंदर है?
भाई चावल है.
वेट, एक मिनट.
चावल है.
हाँ?
सैलड है. और ये वेज करी उन्होंने बना के दे दी है.
वेज करी, आलू की सब्जी. नहीं,
ये वैसे नॉर्मली इसमें नॉन वेज सब होता है ना.
ओके, चिकन पोर्क. तो हमारे लिए स्पेशली वेज थाली बनाई है. कितने की पड़ी है?
पता नहीं है, बहुत सस्ता खाना है.
कितना? फिर भी
10,000 की. 10,000.
ये 10,000 की थाली है लेकिन कयाथ में. चौकी है मत, सिर्फ 10,000 कयाथ, मतलब करीबन 500 रुपीस की ये एक थाली है. 500.
सुबह देखो भैया, हमने बेक्ड बीन और चावल मिला के खाए थे, राजमा चावल बना के.
और अब ये चावल है और ये दाल का सूप है, तो दोनों मिला के खाया जा रहा है.
दाल चावल बना के.
दाल चावल.
सो बिग डे इन द रोड ट्रिप. वी आर हैविंग अ मीटअप विद बाइकर्स फ्रॉम बगान. Quite a spectacle in the market. I do not know if these people are used to see such a big group of bikers together. The two on big bikes, because mostly the bikes that are here are those underbones.
So this is three different groups. This is, these two riders are from Warlord Riders motorcycle group, and then we have Bikers of Bagan, then Burma Red Dragon Motorcycle Club. Check this out.
Check it out. This is Myanmar.
This is Myanmar Bagan. It's not even a capital city. And the amount, number of bikers that have come to meet us on a rainy day, it's pretty amazing. And there's the icing on the cake with that temple behind us. It's amazing.
After the group photo here, we headed to one more beautiful pagoda for our interactive session with the bikers.
Minglaba. Say one more time. Minglaba. Thank you.
So, unexpected number of bikers here in Myanmar. We are going to start very soon, and it's all about telling what we do in India and how they do motorcycling in Myanmar. So let's go.
It was our first meet with the bikers in Myanmar, and we were literally blown away by the love shown by these bikers. Some of them who had ridden all the way from Yangon, which was 800 kilometers one way.
This is Easy 9 and Motorcycle Club and Pakoku. Apparently they were formed in 2016. And that's what we should do, like we should ride easy without any tension. Thank you so much. This is Bagan Biker Group. And these are the colors in their Myanmar flag. And so, and who is he? Like who's
the king? That's the generator,
the one the hero for everything. Yeah. Okay, he's the original king. So since 2017. So if we look that most of the clubs are quite new, young. Okay, thank you so much. So we just had Easy Riders give us a gift. Now they've gone a step ahead. They're simple free bikers. So you know, this is all prevalent in Buddhist countries. In Bhutan, they were doing a lot of rides for charity. And here they also try to practice a simple, normal, easy like kind of life through motorcycle, which is still not there in India. You know, we like fast bikes. I mean, we don't have that kind of a thought culture, most of us. But anyway, thank you so much. So they are called Warlord Riders. And they have come from 70 kilometers away from here, which is around 1.5 hours, 1 hour. They are giving us these stickers. Three of them will go on the bikes right now. and two of them will go on the community wall at our ex-BHP office. So thank you so much for that. So they're called Mingyan Biker Group. This one, they have come from 80 kilometers away. I mean, I cannot imagine someone in India would do that. But I mean, all I can say is thank you to them. And I really feel good and bad at the same time because they've come from so far and it's raining outside. But let me enjoy the moment. They're okay. Called Active Riders. I was thinking that only in India they have such kind of creative names, but here also they have. But if I try to ask them right now, it would be too long a conversation because of translation reasons. But yes, I'm feeling so happy that I have a lot of gifts from here. And it's good that we have an escort, you know, because they have a car. Otherwise, we wouldn't be able to take them on the bikes. So again, thank you to them. So if someone comes to India, you know that there's a biker group from another country. Would you ride 200 kilometers to meet them in another city? But these guys have come all the way from Mandalay to meet us 200 kilometers one way. I don't have any words to say. I'm blown off. And they have this true biking spirit. I mean, there's nothing else which can justify it. Because we are not movie stars. We are just simple bikers. And they have come all the way to meet us 200 kilometers one way. I'm repeating again and again because I still don't believe it. And they are presenting us this. And the stickers which we will treasure for a very long time. And if you look at the emblems on the jacket, you know, they are like very neat. They're from Kakoku, which is around 70-80 kilometers from here. And I really like the logo. You know, just check out the logo. And it is funny that, you know, motorcycling speaks the same language. And even the logos all around the world of different motorcycling groups, I have found that inevitably they have the cylinders, or they have a helmet, or they have a tire, or they have flames. I mean, it is like the universal language of motorcyclists. I don't think there is any other hobby or passion which unites people of different languages in such a way. I mean, I cannot talk to him right now properly. Maybe, you know, a lot of people don't. I mean, because I don't know Burmese. So, but we don't need to. You know, we rode, we had a lot of fun, and that is what motorcycling is all about.
800
kilometers. So, let me get this straight. That I was talking about someone coming from Mandalay, which is 200 kilometers one way, but they have come from 400 kilometers one way. 800 kilometers one way. I'm sorry. One way, 800 kilometers from Yangon. I don't know what to say. It's like an iron butt. Cumulative, like 1600 kilometers just to meet us. Is that right? Just to meet us?
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you so much, sir. I mean, I have no words. I and they're giving us a t-shirt, which is, you can see, this is one of the most beautiful logos I have seen. Now, what is this here?
It's
a dragon.
It's a dragon. It's a dragon, which we saw a lot in Bhutan. I want to tell them that I'm very honored, and I mean, if they come to India, Delhi especially, so I will try to arrange motorcycles for them, and I will try to help them in every possible way.
Guru, if India lalu sini, lalu kerja tu, sange yang pun, sange tu pun meh. Lalu si ni pun, ni aku pun punya. Nakai bawa ke bawa.
We are thankful to each and every biker who participated in this meet and helped us organize it.
So right now we are sitting in our hotel lounge, and there's going to be a cultural show here at the hotel. So it's going to be a good fun evening. Let's see.
So in about 3-4 days, it will be almost a month on the road on the XBHP Domina Great Asian Odyssey. And right now, we are in Myanmar. This is our fourth day and fourth country out of 11. And behind me, as you can see, there are a lot of pagodas, but this is nothing in front of what we saw yesterday. Thousands of them. And this is indeed a beautiful place. But the best part is that you can actually ride along with the pagodas. They are very accessible, the temples and the pagodas, and they give you a whole Indiana Jones kind of feeling. Today it's a little bit longer, 350 kilometers. We're going to another place called Inle Lake, which is still in Myanmar, and it's supposed to be very beautiful. Maybe kind of, which, you know, probably would remind me like Dal Lake in Srinagar. But we hope to have a different kind of experience over there with the boats and everything, and let's see what happens. So far so good, around 5,000 kilometers done. Still a long way to go, but this area is going to be always humid. I don't think we'll see cold now, like the cold weather we are used to seeing in hill stations in India. But that's how it is, and at least the rain is not that much. So that's the best part. See you guys. This was one of the most entertaining days for us, as it was a big festival in Myanmar on that day. And the entire country was in a celebration mood.
Now, what is this happening? So we are leaving from Bagan and towards Inle Lake, and this is quite interesting on my right. Look at this makeshift roof. Wow, this beats the BMW C2, right? Effectively, this is our first traffic jam in Myanmar. Not a big one, but nevertheless. And look at all those posters. I wonder what they are for. And there's a tank on my left being transported. Check this out. Damn. And there are more tanks coming. A line of tanks. And this is probably an iconic video, movement. Tank on the left and a standard transport on the right. More tanks. Well. So, some sort of procession with kids. This is quite amazing. The first railway crossing in Myanmar. Oh, this is actually by the roadside, and look how beautiful is this. This Peter is a pagoda.
Mm-hmm.
And what does it represent? What is it written over there?
Yeah, the name of this pagoda is called Begin. Begin means like to be safe for those who are making adventure trips or like going to the pagoda, buying car or buying bike. We always making a wish.
Okay.
So if you're going to make a wish something, but especially when we are making the adventure trips, you can pay respect to the Buddha.
Okay.
So then,
by
so
whether,
yeah, of course. Okay. And also while we are like making a wish or worshiping to the Buddha, we have to make our hand like this, not like that.
Okay.
Because while we are going to greet to the people, like to say hi or hello in
yes.
Myanmar, Mingalaba, yes. You can use your hand like this.
Okay.
Mingalaba, namaste.
Okay.
If you're going to worship to the Buddha, you cannot do it. You have to make your hand like lotus flowers.
Oh, okay.
This is how we have to pay respect or worship to the Buddha.
Okay.
Like
all
this.
All right, so I can go and do that right now?
Yep, of course. And also, everywhere in the world, you can see the three positions of the Buddha.
Yes.
Sitting position.
Yes.
Standing and reclining position
yes.
of Buddha. So okay. mostly we can see lots of sitting Buddha. And also whenever you look at the sitting Buddha, the Buddha hands is always touching to the earth or the ground.
Yes.
That means because in his previous lifetime, he always do the good deeds. Not only the Buddha evenness, we have to do the good deeds. Whenever we do the good deeds, we have to share our good deeds to all beings, including the guardians of the ground. So that's why whenever you look at the sitting Buddha, his hand is always touching to the ground. That means touching earth mudra. But even you do the yoga, there are different kinds of mudra, over 100 kinds of mudra in the Buddha's positions.
Okay.
But mostly in general, we can see only 5 kinds of mudra, like touching to the ground, and like a blessing to the people, or meditation as well. So this is how we're going to see the different kinds of mudra of Buddha.
Okay.
Yep.
So I will pay my respects right now.
Yes, you can pay respect and you don't need to tell anybody, just in your mind you can make a wish.
Yes, okay. Alright, so this is midway to Inlilik, and look at this structure on my left. Oh, this is in the form of a giant ship. This is humongous. It's pretty amazing because these kind of things are not there in India. I mean, this is actually middle of a market, and it's not even supposed to be a touristy place, I reckon. So let's go back for one more view. Huge is an understatement. Earth is beautiful. So this is pretty amazing. We were going to Inlilik and we found these guys from Myanmar, and they were heading to Bagan, the place that we are coming from today. And there is an R1 also for a change. I mean, a super bike, that is. You're local?
We go to Bagan.
Okay, Bagan.
Yeah.
We're coming from Bagan.
Oh, okay.
Nice bike, man. I'm Sunil. Hi.
Hi, Sunil.
From India.
India.
Yeah. Hi. I'm Sunil from India. We are from India. Delhi to Singapore.
Yeah. And now where you go?
Inlilik.
Inlilik?
Yeah.
Go to Tangji.
Yeah, Inlilik, then Thailand, and then Singapore.
पूरे म्यांमार में एक चीज़ और देखने को मिल रही है मुझे, वो ये है कि जितने भी लोग ट्रैवल कर रहे हैं लोकल्स, वो ऐसे ही ट्रैवल कर रहे हैं, मतलब पीछे बैठ के, कोई सीट नहीं है, कोई कुछ नहीं है, सारे के सारे बैठे हुए हैं, मस्ती में चल रहे हैं। और ये देखिए बच्चे भी हैं और सारे के सारे हैं यहाँ पर, और सभी खुश हैं। बाय बाय।
Thank you.
talking about. So I think these are the national holidays here in Myanmar, and in front of me, as I pass through another town, there are a lot of people gathered on the roadside. I'm not sure what are they doing, but there seems to be something very important. Okay. They, of course, we don't understand their traditions, but it seems very harmonious. Everyone seems happy, and nobody's forcing anyone to do anything. That is what I have understood till now. On my right is a CB400. They are apparently very popular here in Myanmar, and they are imported from Thailand. They cost around 1.5 lakh rupees. This is a 2004 model. And these amazing wide mountain roads, they're quite rare here in Myanmar. Because this is the first time I'm experiencing this, so it's feeling quite nice. But in a lot of turns like this, the road quality is quite bad, I guess due to landslides. Reminds me a bit of Thailand and Malaysia, especially Genting Highlands, that we will go in Malaysia, of course. I really don't know what has happened to the roads, but this is like a racetrack, and this is a toll gate, so I think the good road is going to finish here, or is it actually going to start? And these are the highlands on the way to Inlilik. Wow, it looks slippery, and it's kind of cold here, which is a very rare thing in Myanmar, because all we have been experiencing is humidity, hot and humid. So why is this road wet? Because it wasn't raining just 100 meters ago, and it's not raining here. This is a race track. So I believe that this area is actually the more developed Myanmar, and up till now we were just passing through around 1,000 kilometers of the the west side is not that developed. Sorry, the northwest. This is somewhere south center. Yes, we met them earlier, and now how are you?
How are you?
Good.
You are Sunny, no, Sunny.
Sunny, yes. good.
So where are your friends?
They are, I don't know, way back.
Okay. All yeah. Right. So where are you off to?
Inle Lake. Are you going to Inle?
Yeah, Inle.
Inle?
Yeah.
Ah, let's go.
The final few kilometers to Inle Lake were the finest tarmac we had seen in Myanmar till now. It was a road built through the mountains, yet so wide that you could go on with all guns blazing.
This is a crazy sunset. Look at the valley. Oh God.
Found a lot of traffic on the way, and by the time we reached Inle Lake, it was already dark and we couldn't see anything. But we knew that the next morning is going to be special.